Hey everyone, I'm Jerryjfunk, manager of the Laser Tag League and captain of the Blue Blazers. This is GokouZWar, full-time official for the league. Just wanted to give everyone who maybe hasn't followed Season 2 so closely a quick recap of how the league went, and then we'll turn to GokouZWar for some commentary. So we had a very exciting regular season. The Red Razors came out and were immediately the favorites. They started dominating early on. They actually ended up going 10-0 for the regular season, so they were undefeated, the only undefeated team. Tangerine Taggers ended up in second place with 7 wins, 3 losses. A very tough team to beat, although they couldn't eke out a win against the Red Razors. Then my team, Blue Blazers, came in third place from there. Had a really rough start. Immediately beat by Red in their first game, and then beat by Tangerine Tiger's second game. So we came out of the gate with 4 losses immediately, but ended up picking up steam from there. Purple Punks came out pretty much the same way. Lost a bunch of games in the beginning of the season, ended up picking up steam. They picked up Stefferp, which is a great player, mid-season. He really helped them, and they actually almost beat Red in the semifinals. That was a really exciting game to watch. Grand Slam Green and Blackout Squadron filled out the 5th and 6th positions for the league. So given that you officiated most of the matches throughout the season, what are you seeing, and what were the most exciting games of the season, and what do you think of the two teams going into the championship?
Well, I got to say, there was some pretty amazing games all season long. Even the regular season games, we had a lot of great matches in the match. And we had probably some of the biggest changes happen throughout the middle of the season. We can talk about that if you want. But basically, the way I see it is that we had a lot of ups and downs, but we had a pretty dominating group of Red on the Red team. They had solid games all across the board, but they got done really early, so they've got a lot of delay time where they haven't played much games in the league, and I think that might actually work to your guys' advantage on the Blue team, having everybody constantly, you know, slapping hands and throwing grenades. Anyway,
so you think that Red playing a lot of early games and then having a break is going to help Blue team potentially, because they might be off their game?
Yeah, potentially. I mean, Red team really struggled yesterday taking on Purple Punks. I think they were actually kind of caught off guard when they went against them yesterday, because they had all of that downtime, and then they come in there thinking they're going to just waltz right over the Purple Punks and just keep on rolling as they did all season long. And then next thing we know, Purple Punks comes from behind 2 times. Even they did it both maps. They did it in Hangar 1 and Hangar 2 and came back. Even on the first map on CJC, they were really fighting at the end, and they made it go the full length of that match, and that turned out to be a pretty exciting match. But yeah, it's anybody's game right now. I think Red might be a little bit slumping right now. Maybe they're realizing, hey, we probably ought to go ahead and get back in the practice arena and try again before they go against you guys later in the week. But you know, it's anybody's game right now.